Another cause which has also accounted for collapse of buildings in Nigeria is the use of substandard materials. For this, the materials testing laboratory has a responsibility to check and ensure that the right mix of concrete, quality of steel, among other things, are used.
To stem this tide, material test laboratory has been empowered by the state government to ensure that we go around the entire state and ensure that we test all buildings under construction and all buildings that have been constructed and are standing. And we need to be sure that these buildings will stand the test of time. And that's what we've done. You will not see us in the office again. You see most of us in all the sites. We are at Lekki Gardens carrying out several tests to ensure that those buildings are still okay. Now we are even going not only in Lekki Gardens, we have visited the entire state. Before now, I think we've been concentrating on the superstructure. But now what we do now is that, you know, foundation is the key. What we do now is that when you get your approval to start construction, you now forward your structural drawings and the soil report to material testing laboratory for us to assess. And after assessment, you give us at least 48 hours notice before you start the construction. So that when you now want to start construction, you call us, we are there. We have about 4 branch offices. We have at Lekki, we have at Alimosho, we have at Suwilere, and we have at Atikorodu. So when you invite us, we are there. Before you start your construction, then we take samples of the materials you want to use for construction. Take samples of the concrete, take samples of the steel, sample of water you want to use, and even the blocks you want to use.
These materials are subject to laboratory tests. In the concrete unit, for instance, concrete cubes from construction site are tested for strength using a compressor machine.
Where it comprises of the monotronic and the printer. So, as you can see them, by the time they feed the cubes into the machine, the officer in charge has to, you know, start the machine. So, by the time it's subjected to load, from what we have seen here, it will fail under load after it has been subjected to that load. So after it has failed, the monotronic automatically store the load in kilonewton and the compressive strength. The essence of testing this cube is for us to determine the strength of the structural members on site. It's just a representative of what is being done on site. For example, now if you are building a house, you have the columns, the beams, and the slabs. Those are the structural members. So on site, by the time they are mixing and pouring the concrete to make those structural members, so it is expected of the laboratory to be on that site to take part of the concrete mix on the site, and that is what you've seen here.
There is the geotechnical unit where materials like sand, cement, granite, and other aggregates are tested for salty content and other components.
For road construction, you have to, you know, determine the type of bitumen that you want to use on before, you know, finally lay it on the road before you finally use it, you know, and mix it with sand and some other aggregate before it becomes your asphalt, before you finally lay it on the road surfaces. So these tests are very, very important, like penetration tests, like a softening point test on bitumen.
Water samples from building sites are also subject to tests.
We want to determine whether the water contains iron, whether it contains calcium, magnesium, and some other chemical parameter. Because the essence of it is that, you know, when you mix water with cement and sand and granite, there's tendencies for corrosivity, maybe to corrode the iron use, you know, during construction. So we want to be sure that the water used are free of all these chemical parameters. So that is why we mandated that they should bring the water from the site for further laboratory analysis.
There are other tests which have been infused into the system to ensure that buildings in Nigeria do not become death trap, and all citizens are required to follow the procedure.
Before you construct your building, you must have gotten your approval you must present all your papers to Ministry of Physical Planning. And even we have an agency there, LASFIDA, which also deals with approvals. You must get your approval. Before you get your approval, they will assess the drawing that you want to construct, and they check what exactly you want to build on that soil. And when they do that, they now forward it to us for further action.
It's safe to say that no one likes the sight nor the consequences of collapsed building. Apart from the lives lost, it also brings loss of investment. So it seems the route of the law is cheaper to follow. Citizens could contribute by reporting threatening buildings. You can use the Big Story platform to share that information, and we would send it to the appropriate agency. We hope to hear from you soon. I'm Minnie Thompson.